Hello everyone, Charles Watts here, the Arsenal correspondent at Goal, joining you on Tuesday as we gear towards Arsenal's first game of pre-season, which is just 3 days away now. Arsenal taking on Nuremberg on Friday, 4:30pm kickoff, I think that is UK time, so looking forward to that. We could well be seeing some new recruits in action as well, because Gabriel Jesus appears to have gone over. I have to admit, I thought they were coming back next week, all the international players, but it appears some of the international players have come back a little bit earlier. There's still none of the European players who went away, like the England players, William Saliba, I believe Martin Odegaard as well. Those sort of players, they are still having a bit of time off, Granit Xhaka. But in terms of the players who maybe were playing South American football, so the Brazilians anyway, they are back. We saw the pictures yesterday from Arsenal. We had Gabriel Jesus, we had Gabriel Martinelli, Gabriel, the centre-back. Sorry, honestly, so many Gabriels, it's going over the top of my head. Marquinhos was there as well. The four Brazilians all pictured together at London Colony, so that was good to see. And I believe they have gone out over to Germany, so we could well be getting our first look at Gabriel Jesus in an Arsenal shirt on Friday. If we do, I imagine that would be just for a short period of time. I could see it being 45 minutes, as I said yesterday, 45 minutes of the senior players in the first half, and maybe 45 minutes of the younger players, because a whole host of the younger players have gone over there, like Patino, those sort of players, Murray Hutchinson, Salah, and those sort of players, where they could be playing in the second half. So it'll be interesting to see, but good to see Gabriel Jesus meeting up with his teammates yesterday, all smiles, and as you can imagine, just having that sort of core group of Brazilians is going to certainly make life an awful lot easier for him to settle, you would think, and that's positive. Mikel Arteta spoke about it during his interview that was on Arsenal.com yesterday, and also Marquinhos as well, who's obviously very, very young, and this is a whole new world for him coming over from South America and settling into a new club, into a new climate, just having to, you know, everything, new culture, having those Brazilians around him, it's going to be really, really helpful for a young player like that, especially someone like Martinelli, who, you know, it's just a couple of years ago, is doing exactly the same thing, so he can feed off Martinelli, get his advice, and I think that could be really, really beneficial. And I'm looking forward to seeing what Marquinhos can offer during pre-season, because these sort of players like Martinelli, obviously Guendouzi, when he first came in, we saw them just sort of hit the ground running in pre-season and make big, big impression. And if Marquinhos can do that as well this summer, then, you know, that could potentially solve a bit of an issue for Arsenal. And they, you know, he could be in and around the first team rather than having to find a club to send him out on loan. So looking forward to that. The squad flew out yesterday afternoon to Germany, where they will be staying sort of in and around where the big Adidas HQ is there. So I think there will be a couple of commercial opportunities that the players will be taking up while they're in Germany. I'm not too sure what we're going to see from Arsenal in terms of coverage on Arsenal.com or anything like that from the stay. It is very much being used as a proper training camp. You know, I'm sure the pre-season tour to the US, that sort of thing, we're going to see lots of commercial stuff done and players going here, there and everywhere, meeting people and sponsors and that sort of thing. I'm not sure it's going to be quite as blatant as that during this trip to Germany. Arsenal are using it, like I said, very much as a training camp. There's only been 1 week of pre-season. Remember, you know, this is serious stuff. It's about getting as much energy and fitness and everything into those players' legs and getting some of the new boys acclimatised as well. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see what we see from Arsenal in terms of their coverage on Arsenal.com. But they are streaming the game live on Friday, so we're all going to be able to watch that wherever you are. Hopefully around the world you can tune in and see Arsenal in action for the first time. And the first game of the season, the Premier League season, is exactly a month away. Can you believe that? We are 1 month away. I think it's the 5th today, isn't it, of June, the 5th of July, 5th of July, sorry, today, I think it's 5th of August is Arsenal's opening game against Crystal Palace, so not much time left until that opening trip to Selhurst Park on the Friday night, so Arsenal very much need to get this pre-season under their belts, get themselves fit, healthy and ready to go in what is a very tricky game at Crystal Palace on the opening day. In just a couple of things just on transfers. Well, just one thing really, just on Lisnadro Martinez. I put out a little update on Twitter today. There's not really much going on with him at the moment in terms of sorts of things that have moved forward. I spoke about it yesterday, so I've just been getting lots of questions about him, but it's not really moved forward, I'm afraid, certainly as far as I'm aware anyway. So we're just going to have to wait and see how this week progresses with Martinez. It's, you know, he has returned now from his holiday. He was back in Amsterdam yesterday. He had a meeting yesterday with Ajax. This is the second meeting he's had now. This is the first time he's done it in Amsterdam. And again, he reiterated, as far as I'm aware, his desire to move to the Premier League, his determination to move to the Premier League this summer. He's made that very, very clear to Ajax. But as it stands, Ajax have not accepted any bids for Arsenal or from Manchester United or anyone else. And until they do, then, you know, he's going nowhere. The expectation, as I've reported before, certainly amongst those close to Martinez, is that his desire to move to the Premier League this summer will eventually mean that Ajax will allow him to go or soften their stance and accept some sort of offer that comes in. But as it stands, they are playing hardball. They haven't accepted anything. And, you know, Man United, Arsenal, or anyone else who might be interested in him are going to have to meet what Ajax are wanting for him. As I've reported before, there is a feeling again amongst those closer to him that the Ten Hag connection does probably give Man United a slight advantage, say if both clubs had bids accepted. But he does like Arsenal. He likes Arteta's ideas. And, you know, he hasn't closed the door on Arsenal. So we'll just wait and see how that one progresses. But so that's the latest on Martinez. Just hasn't really moved forward that much in the last sort of 24, 48 hours or so. I was quite interested by Mikel Arteta's interview yesterday, speaking about Gabriel Jesus after his arrival. We saw Jesus speaking about it and talking about where he wants to play, that sort of thing, very much spelling out that he is a number nine and he sees himself as a number nine. Arteta was talking very, very glowingly about him yesterday and about the move, paid tribute to Arsenal for getting the deal done for a player of his stature. He spoke about Jesus's versatility in that, but as I said, he very much sees him as the central striker in that attacking trio that he's going to play, whoever the wide players are. But what Arteta wants from his attackers are all that they can interchange and move, and there's a very fluid sort of rotational feel almost to that front three, where everyone can play, can be comfortable in whatever position they get asked to play. He was asked about Jesus and his sort of best attributes. Said he's an incredible professional with his work ethic and enthusiasm. You will see it in the first day he puts his boots on and enters the training pitch. He has the enthusiasm that he's going to create on his own on that pitch. And then obviously there are his qualities, his hunger to score, his willingness to be coached, to improve. He's used to winning, and he knows that winning is the only way to do it. I think he will set different standards at the club. I thought that was quite a key comment there. He will set different standards. Now, we've all heard Arteta ahead of this transfer window saying that this was the time to take Arsenal to the next level. This was the transfer window that where Arsenal needed to go to the next level in terms of bringing in that type of quality player that's going to help them bridge the gap from the teams towards the top. And I think when he talks about Jesus setting different standards there, that's exactly what he means. That's the type of player he wants to bring in, winners. I mean, Jesus has won 4 Premier Leagues in 5 or 6 years, however long he's been at Manchester City. He's won 3 Carabao Cups, he's won the FA Cup. He knows all about winning, and they're the sort of players he wants to bring in now to this Arsenal squad. Players who can come in with that sort of mentality that the younger players are already in the team can feed off and learn from. And I think Gabriel Jesus will do that, and that's why I just think it's such a really exciting signing for this one for Arsenal. I think it's a really, really smart piece of business for relatively cheap. I mean, you look at 45 million, you think back to January when everyone was, you know, it was like spend 75, 80 million on Vlahovic, spend 70 odd million, pay the release clause for Isaac. And then you think you've got Gabriel Jesus now for 45 million. It's just kind of makes sense why you don't go splashing all that cash on a whim in January when you could kind of wait for the summer. I'm not excusing Arsenal for their January business by any means saying that, because I absolutely think they should have found a replacement for Aubameyang in January, even if it was just a loan deal, get someone in to give Arteta another option. But I can absolutely understand why they didn't, you know, throw money at someone just for the sake of it, when in their mind they knew they could wait till the summer and get a player of Jesus's quality for around, I don't know, 40, 45 million pounds. And I know a lot of people are looking at that transfer fee and the fact he only had a year left in his contract and thinking maybe it's a little bit too much money. But I'm sorry, if you sign Gabriel Jesus for, you know, 25-year-old, his quality, his pedigree, and you only pay 45 million to get him, I think it's a pretty good piece of business. And I can't imagine in a couple of years we're going to be looking at that deal and think Arsenal have got the sort of worst side of it by any means. I think I'm very confident that Gabriel Jesus will be a success. And like I said, hopefully we'll get to see him on Friday in that first game of pre-season, which is now only 3 days away. that's it from me today. Thanks for watching, everyone. Just a bit of a short, sharp one for you. Thank you for watching. Have a very good day, and I will speak to you soon.